And this is the third video in the series where I show you how to migrate from Lightspeed to Shopify. And this third video is about orders. How do you migrate orders from Lightspeed to Shopify? And here I have one sample order in my Lightspeed fake store, obviously, because I don't have the real one, especially in Lightspeed. So we just press export orders and choose to export everything, and we wait, and it should be done by now. But let's go to the tools, exports, and here it is. It shows that it has exported, and now we just press download, and it downloads this orders export file. And in order to for Excelify to understand that these are Lightspeed orders, we just add the Lightspeed to the file name so that the file has two words at least in it, Lightspeed and orders. And then we go to the Excelify app in Shopify, obviously, and then we click here to add the file, choose this file, allow it to upload, and then it's estimating, and then it shows that it found indeed the format is Lightspeed, and it found one order in this file. And again, as with all the other imports, we could press import right away and import this order, or we could do the dry run, which would generate the import results file without importing, and so that we can review the file, the clean up the data, check that everything is okay, and only then upload that file, the modified converted file, and import it. But for the sake of example, let's just go the kamikaze way and do the import straight away, because it will fail. I know it will. Yeah, so it failed. And also in this case, we can just download the import results and check why did it fail. We just open the results file, and here, let's zoom in a bit. So here we have all those fields that we can possibly get out from the orders file, which comes from Lightspeed. Any like additional details which didn't have any specific place, you will see in the additional details of the orders. And then comes the customer information, all the billing address, the shipping address, the line items, any more additional fields that didn't have any specific place, the transactions, if the payment was made, so we will generate a transaction for you, the fulfillment, if the order was fulfilled, we'll generate the fulfillment for you. And we will put all the Lightspeed specific fields which didn't have the place in the order, in the Shopify fields. We'll put them in as orders meta fields here in the Lightspeed namespace. Those are the meta fields which you can also review later and maybe use for some purpose. But here, in this case, because our order failed, we need to know why it failed. So we look into the import comment field in the column. And here we see that the customer phone is invalid. So our customer doesn't have a valid phone because Shopify is very strict. It validates emails and the phone numbers so that they would be correct by the certain rules. And actually, it validates emails very strictly so that not only it's like correct syntax, but it actually asks the mail server whether such mailbox exists in that server. So you might have quite a lot of failed orders because of if the email is not valid. So I'll just put a phone number. We still need this plus, because otherwise it doesn't see that it's the country prefix. Now we close it, we go back, and we import the file. Press import. Voila! New one order. Now we go to orders, press refresh, and here it is. It has migrated. Now we can see that it's paid, fulfilled, all the amounts, and here are those additional details which come from the Lightspeed, the order ID, the invoices, what was the Lightspeed status, so that you can see everything, every detail that you might need. And it's even linked to the correct customer, which we migrated in our previous tutorial. Now, if we open that customer, we'll see that it indeed has one order now. And what's cool about it, when you will activate your migrated customers, they will register in your Shopify system, and they will be delighted to see that all their order history is there, which is really, really nice. All right, so let us know what you are missing, and if you have any issues with the migrations, if you need any help, reach out to our support. Cheers, and see you around. Bye.